Hi, everybody. Thanks for giving me your time to talk to you. So what I'm going to show you is what essentially was my hackathon submission, where I decided to take a different kind of an angle and kind of take the liberty in exploring something that I wanted to do for a while, which is create a game-like experience in SharePoint. So the idea was, you know, I don't know about where you are, but in Ireland, escape rooms and that kind of a game is a big enough thing. So I thought, well, SharePoint can probably do that. So let's give it a go. So I'll get rid of this silly looking slide. I just kind of, I don't know why I did that, just did it. But what I'll do is I'll show you the kind of end user experience of this solution. And then I'll take you through how it's actually structured in the background and how it all works. So the premise of this really is that, so say you've got an initiative or you want to launch something or an intranet or something like that, and you want to bring people into SharePoint and maybe get them a bit excited and just explore it a bit. That's what I'd use this for personally. So I created this fake game called The Great Escape 2025, and this is the landing page for the game. So this is where you point people to give them an introduction to it. So all this was really just a flex on flexible sections, really, pardon the pun. So a way that I could just experiment it with it. When I was creating this first off, flexible sections were really, really new. So it was a good chance to play with it. So anyway, long story short, we've got an intro in here, some metrics that you might pop in here just to entice people to come on further, highlights of the game, and then how it works. Don't worry, I'll show you all that now in a minute. And then we get into the concept of levels. So the way this game works is that it's a progression game. So there's three different levels in my case here, and each level contains a puzzle. And the idea being that you start on level one and you can't progress to level two or level three till you've solved the preceding level. And I'll show you what that looks like in a minute. But that's essentially all it is. It's a simple enough model that you could expand to have more levels or more intricate puzzles. But I'll show you what I did anyway for the moment. So say you were new to this and you wanted to get started, you go begin challenge and you'd come into level one. And this is a separate SharePoint site. So for each of my levels in the game, I created a separate site just because I wanted kind of unique teaming with it and stuff like that. So when you're in here, I won't bore you with all the puzzles, right? But in here, it's basically the structure is the same per site. You give a little clue here, a little riddle, I suppose. And then there's something in here that relates to this that you have to submit a code that you work out. So long story short in here, there's a puzzle here that relates to each of these images. When you arrange the images in line with the sentences here, you take the first letter from each image and you get the keyword gold, right? Or the code word, I should say. And that's kind of why I had chosen an Inca looking fella here. So the idea is you figure that out. You come in here, you say submit your code. And what we're using here is a form that's created from a list that sits in the background. But don't worry about that. I'll show you that in a minute. And you got to put in your code. Now put validation on the field here. So if you enter in the wrong code, you can't progress. And my first kind of iteration of this, I let them input anything and then I used Power Automate to check it. But it was kind of slow in terms of turnaround. People had to wait for it to be evaluated and come back with a response. So putting the field level validation kind of sorted that out. So the code is gold, but if I typed in silver, for example, and clicked submit, we have a kind of passive aggressive, incorrect, you got that, you got to get the answer right, dummy, right? So that's what happens there. But assuming they do get it right, okay, we run some flows in the background, which essentially gives them access to level two. So then they'll get communication about that, then they'll come on to level two and rinse and repeat, right? It's another clue with some cryptic kind of a puzzle, submit your code to a separate list, get it right, move on, hit level three, and away you go. And that's kind of what it is from their perspective. They're kind of going through this game, trying to solve the puzzles as quick as they can. And how they can kind of keep track of things, well, if we're back on our kind of home site, there's a leaderboard page. And one of the big things that Power Automate is doing here is that every time somebody submits a correct answer, we have a leaderboard list in the background of this site. And then we can see their progress. So it's a lonely tenant with just me in it, right? So I only completed it. But if anyone else does and they're on level one, level two would say, not started yet. Level three, not started yet. If they come to level two, it'll say working on it. And then this will say not started yet. And once they've submitted the correct answer for level three, we calculate their total time it took them to complete the game, I suppose. And that's how we figure out who's at the top of the leaderboard versus bottom of the leaderboard or in progress. It's essentially it. I'll take a breath for a sec. But yeah, not too much to it, really. I kind of kept it fairly simple in terms of the puzzle was just contained within the page. But, you know, since thinking about it, think there's a million different ways you can create interesting puzzles. I suppose the thing would be to be careful that someone doesn't hit the old Copilot agent for the site and, you know, find the clue that way. So I think the kind of images versus other things are a way to protect against that. But I didn't consider that at the time. It just came to me afterwards. So anyway, that's that bit, right? So if we look at how it's actually structured and how it works, so hopefully you can all see this, okay? This is kind of like a blueprint of the game, right? So this big white box here is that landing site, and that's really the engine that sits, which the game works off. And then we've got our individual level sites down here. We really only have them containing a page at the moment, so they're not too important. But the way this kind of works in here is, well, we've got two pages on the site, simple enough. The landing page, which you've seen, the leaderboard page, which you've seen, right? And then we've got a number of lists. So the first list we have is the leaderboard list, and we're just embedding a view of this list onto this page. And then we have three additional lists, each list, you know, aligning with a level of the game. So every time you submit through the form, it pops into here and you've created your entry. So you can only get in here if you got the question right, because remember, we had that validation. So when you submit to here, what this workflow will do, or this Power Automate flow will do, it's going to basically add you to a security group. So I created these two security groups, one for level two and one for level three. So if we come down here into level two, that's this group here, and that has a visitor level of permission on this site. So by completing the first level right, this is going to add you into this site and you get access to it. And then we can do some other cool things because we have a group to target for audience targeting. I'll pop back into SharePoint in a minute and show you that. So that's how that works, right? Similarly, what will happen after you first get onto this list, we're also going to add you onto this list because you've effectively started the game, you've made progress, so we capture you there. And then these other workflows in here are very similar. I'll show you them now in a second, but they're very similar. So when I complete, when I submit to level two successfully, this will trigger. It's going to look for your record in here, and then it's going to update it to say you finished level two and now you're working on level three. And we do that the same for level three as well. And then we've got our kind of fourth workflow up here, which is going to calculate total time. So this is based on a condition. So it basically looks at this list every time an item in it is kind of modified. And what it's going to do is say, well, did they complete level three yet? That's the first condition. And then there's a second condition, which is going to stop this getting into an endless loop because this flow itself is going to update the item. So that can happen that way. But that's kind of it. It's fairly straightforward, really. We manage access through security groups. We remove people's permission to this list, obviously, so they don't see the answers. But because we have this really nice way to create forms within a list that people can submit to without actually needing access to the list, that really was massive in making this work. So yeah, some props to Microsoft for making that happen for us. So what I'll do is I'll give you a quick look. I set a timer here on my desk and I forgot to press start on it, right? So I'll keep an eye on the clock. I'll finish up soon, David. So we're back in here on the site, right? So I'll come back to the homepage. Some things on this with the audience targeting and stuff like that. Give it a quick scram there. Right, so I'll put the page into edit mode. And then I'll put the page out of edit mode because I meant to say something before I put it into edit mode. Sorry. So what I'll do is I'll come down here, right? And one of the things down here is I wanted to advertise the levels to people, okay? So you begin here, but I didn't want people to access this level until they've got here. And no, I didn't want to put a link there and they click it and they get the default, you don't have access to this, right? I didn't think that was the most graceful way to do that. So I need these locked until they get access to it. So the way I did that, again, flexible sections made it possible for me to do it in the fact that we can overlay web parts on top of each other. So for level two, I actually do have the link there, but you see the icon here, it's telling me it's audience targeted. So that link will only display when you're a member of this group. So when you have access. So if you've got access, this quick links web part sits on top of that text there. So you don't see the text, you see the button. So it makes it look like it's been unlocked for you. But when you're not in the group, you obviously don't see this web part. So you just see the text that sits below it. It's a really, it's not a fancy solution around like that. Like it really was just a kind of a hack, I suppose. But it seems to work all right. So I was happy with it. So that's kind of some things we can do like that. Also, because we have the groups, I have the navigation of peer audience targeted as well. So if you have access to level two, you'll see an easy link to get to it. Things like that are pretty straightforward. If I come into site contents for the moment, I'll just show you one of those submission lists, and they're mercilessly easy, right? So in the submission list level one, all it is a standard list, but I just added in this item in here, which is to contain the code word that gets submitted. So we have the forms we create in here. Here's my level one. I just unticked everything and just left level one visible. So when someone launches the form, that's the only thing they input. But, you know, we still got who created it, when they created it. That metadata gets captured anyway. In terms of the validation, you guys probably know more about this than I do. But in here, I'm basically saying, yeah, you can submit to this field, but only if you submit gold, gold, or gold. And I was just trying to cover the different kind of ways people might spell it. So that's what that does, and that's where you put in your message. So that's all fine. Power Automate, in terms of that, like I said, it's all very simple. I'm not an expert in Power Automate. Half users will scream at me for doing this wrong, I'd say, but it seemed to work for me, so I'm going with it. So this is basically monitoring that level one submission list. So when an item is created, add the user to the level two group, create the item in the leaderboard, and then communicate to the person that, you know, it all went great and they're fantastic. And then we do the same basically for our level two submission, wherever it is, it's in here. When I come in here, everything is the same. We're just adding them to the level three group, but we just have to do a get items where we're looking up the leaderboard list. We're searching for the person's display name, and that's the item that we have. And then in our for each action, we just update the leaderboard. So they've now cracked level one, cracked level two, and they're working on level three, and we calculate the time. So it kind of does that for their level submissions. The last flow, I'll show you it really, really quick, is the leaderboard total time. So again, the trigger on this one is when an item or file is modified within our leaderboard list. And the conditions, like I was saying, are, well, only run when they've finished level three. That's brilliant. And then there's another column in that list called stop update with a default value of no. So when it's no, happy days, run away. So we've met them conditions. What we do is we compose the time. So we know when they create an item in list submission one, right? That's one date. And then we know when they submitted a correct answer in list submission three. So that's our second date. So we just have a function here that calculates the difference between the two. And the date difference function here was really simple. It just did it for me. I didn't have to do anything, to be honest. So we do that. And then we just update our leaderboard list for the final time with the total time. And then we update that stop update value to yes. And that just means that this won't fire off again because it'll fail that first condition. And that's probably about time. I don't know if there's any questions. I probably missed a load of stuff. But in summary, it's just a simple model, right? You're just creating sites. You're moderating access through the groups, and people get to them by answering questions or basically submitting to lists. So fairly basic. You could go bananas with it, I'd say. But yeah, that was my offering. So I'll take a break and leave it there.